The Math Center presents Rules of Exponents. We'll talk about simplifying exponents using four different rules: the product rule, the quotient rule, the negative exponent rule, and the zero exponent rule. We'll start with the product rule. If you multiply two exponents with the same base, you add their exponents. X to the m times x to the n equals x to the m plus n. Here's an example. 2 to the third power times 2 to the fifth power. 2 is the base, so we can add the exponents, and we get 2 to the 3 plus 5, or eighth power. Why does the product rule work the way it does? Let's take a closer look at this example in a more visual way. We're still looking at 2 to the third times 2 to the fifth power. One way to think of 2 to the third power is that you're taking 2 and multiplying it by itself 3 times. So you have 2 times 2 times 2, or 3 factors. For 2 to the fifth power, you have 2 times itself 5 times. So we have 3 factors and 5 factors combined, that gives us 8 factors. When you take 2 to the 8th power, you get 256. You'll need to use a scientific calculator to find the exponent. Here is how to do it with the online calculator from Desmos.com. Type 2, then click on the A to the B key, and some scientific calculators have an X to the Y key, then 8, and your answer is displayed as 256. Your turn to try some. We have 5 to the second power times 5 to the third power. Next is 10 to the 10th power times 10 to the minus 3 power. And finally, 7 to the 3rd power times 6 to the 4th power. At this time, I encourage you to hit the pause button and try these problems on your own. Then hit play when you're ready to go over the solutions. Here are the solutions. For the first one, we have 5 squared times 5 cubed, which is 5 to the 2 plus 3 power, or 5 to the 5th power. This is 5 times itself 5 times, or 3,125. Next, we have 10 to the 10th power times 10 to the negative 3 power. We're going to do the same thing here, adding the exponents. So 10 plus a negative 3 is 7. So we end up with 10 to the 7th power, or 10 million. Finally, for number 3, we have to go back to the definition of the product rule. Remember, to be able to add the exponents together, the bases must be the same. In this case, the bases are 7 and 6, so the bases are not the same. We can't use the product rule, but we can put these into our calculator separately and find the result. Now let's take a look at the quotient rule. We use the quotient rule when we're dividing exponents that have the same base. It's very similar to the product rule, but when you divide exponents, you subtract them. The rule says if you have a base raised to the m power and we divide it by an expression with the same base raised to the n power, then we should subtract n from m for a new exponent. For example, 4 to the 6th power divided by 4 to the 2nd power, the bases are the same, so we can use the quotient rule and subtract the exponents. We get 4 to the 6th minus 2 power, which equals 4 to the 4th power. Remember, when we're dividing, we're going to subtract exponents. Here's another example. X to the 8th power over x to the 4th power. This
is in fraction form, and it means x to the 8th power divided by x to the 4th power. We can use the quotient rule to simplify this by subtracting the exponents. The new power on x is 8 minus 4, which ends up being 4, so our answer is x to the 4th power. Here are two examples for you to try. Hit pause on the video and then hit play when you're ready to go over the solutions. Here's the solution for the first problem. First, we have 7 to the 9th power divided by 7 to the 3rd power. The bases are the same, so we can subtract the exponents. 9 minus 3 is 6, so we have 7 to the 6th power, or 117,649. The second example is a little tricky. We have 11 to the 12th power over 11 to the negative 10th power. Watch out when you subtract here. The new power is 12 minus a negative 10. Remember that subtracting a negative number is the same as adding, so the exponent becomes 12 plus 10, which is 22. Our result is 11 to the 22nd power. If you want to put that in your calculator, you get a very, very big number. You can see why we use exponents. They're a lot more convenient than writing out giant numbers like this one. The third rule we'll cover is the negative exponent rule. The negative exponent rule says that if you have a number, except for 0, raised to a negative power, you can move it to the bottom of a fraction by changing the exponent to a positive. In other words, if you have x to the negative m power, you can rewrite it as 1 over x to the positive m power. In this example, you can see that 5 to the negative 4th power can be rewritten as 1 over 5 to the positive 4th power. Now it's your turn to try. Here are two more examples that you can try on your own. Go ahead and hit the pause button and work out the problems. And when you're done, hit play for the presentation to start again, and we'll go over the solution. Here is the solution to the first problem. Using the negative exponent rule, we can write 2 to the negative 4th power as 1 over 2 to the positive 4th power. It's the same thing as saying 1 over 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 16. So 2 to the negative 4th power is equal to 1 over 16. Our second problem is negative 7 to the negative 2 power. We need to use the order of operations here, which tells us to do the exponent before we deal with the negative sign out in front. So the 7 to the negative 2 power is 1 over 7 squared, and we'll have that negative sign out in front. 7 squared is 49, so our final answer is negative 1 over 49. Our last rule is actually the easiest. The zero exponent rule says that any number except 0 raised to the 0 power is equal to 1. An example would be if we take 6 to the 0 power. Because we are raising it to the 0 power, this equals 1. Here's our last set of practice problems. Pause the video, give these a try, and then hit play to go over the solutions. Here are the solutions. 5 is raised to the 0 power. Since any number raised to 0 equals 1, 5 to the 0 power equals 1. For the second problem, we have to do a little bit of solving before we figure out the answer. We are dividing, so we'll use the quotient rule. 7 to the 4th power divided by 7 to the 4th power equals 7 to the 4 minus 4 power. 4 minus 4 equals 0, so 7 to the 0 power equals 1. Let's sum up the four rules we talked about. When using the product rule, if you are multiplying two exponentials that have the same base, you add the exponents. When using the quotient rule, if you're dividing two exponents that have the same base, you subtract the exponents. When using the negative exponent rule, if you have a number, except for 0, raised to a negative power, you can move it to the bottom of a fraction by changing the exponent to a positive number. And when using the 0 exponent rule, any number except for 0 raised to the 0 power is always 1. Thank you for listening to this Math Center presentation on rules of exponents.